This is a combination of the first four videos in my ongoing YouTube Shorts series, Programming in Assembly. Programming in Assembly, Part 0. To understand assembly, you must first understand how the program is laid out in memory. Let's start by looking at the text section. The text section is where executable instructions are stored. This is the section you probably think of when you think of programming. This is where data is manipulated and used to achieve a certain goal. The next section is the data section. The data section is where you store values that your program will use. For example, in a Hello World program, the Hello World string is stored in the data section and is printed to the console in the text section. Similar to the data section, next is the BSS section. The BSS section also stores values that the program will use. The difference is that the values are uninitialized. For example, user input can be stored in the BSS section, but the value that will be stored is not known until the program is run. The last two sections we will look at are the stack and the heap. The size of the stack and the heap change dynamically throughout the program's runtime, storing various values. The stack is organized because it is first in, last out, meaning it acts like a stack of plates, allowing you to add things on top and remove things from the top, but values cannot be added or removed in the middle of the stack. This organization is both quick and limiting. The heap, on the other hand, is unorganized. Values can be removed from anywhere in the heap, and future values can fill in the gaps created from these removals. The benefit of this is that dynamically sized lists, or lists of values whose size grows throughout the program's execution, can be created in the heap. One implementation is that when a dynamically sized list reaches its capacity, each value is copied to an area in the heap with a larger capacity, and the old values are deleted, leaving room for future values. Now, we will move on to registers and the move command. Registers are little devices in the CPU that hold a number. The CPU can perform various actions on registers to manipulate their values, such as setting their value, moving values between registers, and performing arithmetic with their values. In assembly, the move command allows you to set the value at a destination to a source value. The destination or source can be registers or values relating to memory locations defined in the data or BSS section. The first example is simple. It sets the value at a register to a literal value that you write in. In this example, it is 5. The next example allows you to move a value from a source register into a destination register without altering the value in the source register. The next few examples will use a hypothetical value defined in the data section. The value will be 10 with the label var. This example moves the value defined at var into the register RAX, so RAX is now equal to 10. The next one moves the address where var is stored into RAX. Next, the value at the location where RAX holds an address of is moved into RCX, so RCX is now equal to 10. The final example shows var being set to the value at RAX. Many people have heard of a bit and a byte, but do you know what they are? Also, have you ever heard of a nibble? Bits are the smallest pieces of information that computers use. They are represented using zeros and ones, but physically it just means that there is or isn't the presence of a voltage. Bits and logic gates are the building blocks that make computation possible. Inside CPUs, numbers are represented in base 2, or binary, a numeral system that represents numbers using two symbols. Because computers work in base 2, bits are grouped in powers of 2, starting with 4 bits in a nibble and 8 bits in a byte. If a RAM stick has 8 gigabytes of memory, that's 2 to the power of 20 bytes, or 8 times 2 to the power of 20 bits. In assembly, there is a group of bits called a word, which is 16 bits or 2 bytes. D word, or double word, is the size of 2 words. Q word, or quad word, is the size of 4 words. Can you see what the words spell out in ASCII? Now, let's look into defining values in the data section. When adding something to the data section, you must write a label, a list of values, and the size of each value. The first few examples define a label, a size, and a value to be defined. It is important to note that the label refers to the address where the items are located in memory, not the actual value. To access a value at an address, put brackets around the address. The next examples show how to store characters in memory by surrounding a character with single quotes. Characters in assembly are represented in ASCII, which basically means there is an 8-bit numerical representation for many common characters. In a future video, I will discuss how binary can represent numbers. All you need to know for now is that when defining a character, the size needed is a byte, so use DB. My name refers to the address in memory that is 5 bytes long, each byte containing a letter in my name. Note that even though I wrote DB, the length of the value is 5 bytes. The final example does the exact same thing as the example before, but in a neater fashion. It defines a string using double quotes.